Oh guys, I'm really happy with the H22 because it can print really large prints and it saves a lot of weight by gluing the parts together. 80 millimeter inside, but let's see what weight this model has. I'm really, really proud. Oh, by the way, to give you all an idea about size, I made it slightly bigger. Previous one was the same like this. Okay guys, while we are waiting for parts for the F-35B, the new ESCs, because in the last video the APDs didn't have any airflow and I'm now seeing for the first time that the capacitor is broken. Oof. Anyway, so we need to continue our next project. I'm going to go back also to some laser reviews. As you all guys know, I really like doing reviews about laser systems. So I'm going to do one about the Creality Falcon Pro with a 40 watts laser. But yeah, we're going to start the F-35A version. Fully detailed. It is suited with a JP70, of course, 7S setup. It got also the charge servos installed and it will be listed for you all in RC Jetprint. So make sure you found out the link. The links are in the description and we're going to build a really detailed F-35A. So together with my friend Marijn, we already did some test flying beginning of this year and we decided to continue this project to make it available for you guys. So I would say let's build. This is my friend Norbert from Switzerland. He is doing the Osprey and a really cool helicopter, also of bait. So, we're going to show you guys the F-35A version. It's still loading, but we're going to use the bamboo laps, the H2D, the carbons and the A1s for printing this model. And all the filaments are powered by Colorfabb. So thank you, Colorfabb. Okay guys, I hope you can see it. So the idea is to build it fully scale, also with the washout wings. It will be suited for a 70 millimeter for JP, but also a free wing 80 should fit. So if you crash your Avanti free wing mini, the parts you can use also for this model. That is the idea. So all details are there. Let's see if we can build something really nice. So let's start printing and gluing the fuselage together. Oh, by the way, to give you all an idea about size, I made it slightly bigger. The previous one was the same like this, and I made it slightly bigger, so it's cooler and fit also the 80 now. And starting really to look like an F-35A. I really, really like it. Can't wait to finish the complete fuselage. So let's continue the build. Okay, it's starting to look really awesome, amazing. And I like those two, they are from TC Modelvloer, amazing channel, really fun to watch on the background. Did you guys see this? This is the team, Natalie, Raf, Richard, Peter, the F-35 pilot, Pascal Smal. We got Lei. Got some really special people, wife, Filemon, all my friends, Natalie, Ingmar,
Cool.
Ja, daar is Nathalie. Die ziet Kentje weer sinds tijden.
Okay, look at that. Fuselage is finished. So we're going to continue with the wings. And I prepared already some parts. So let's start gluing and printing the left wing.
Now it's starting like an F-35. So I'm quite happy with the aileron. Works fine. I made a small mistake with the hinge. But for the next wing, I'm going to fix that. So we're going to continue with the vertical stabilizer and the elevators. And it will be, wow, it will be awesome, really. So let's continue the build. The filaments are going really, really fast. So I need to add more filaments into the AMS. The cool thing about the AMS is once this one runs out, it will automatically feed through to the other one. So let's add some Colorfabb for my filament. I'm really happy with the natural color because, you know, let's paint them really cool. Meanwhile, the printers are running to print the left side wing. I made some adjustments on the aileron. And this will take a few hours before I can attach the left wing. And eventually in this video, I wanted also to have it painted because I need to repaint this model, the nose. So I'm going to paint this one as well. So I need also to sand it and make the surface smooth. So let's continue with the vertical stabilizers. Oh wow, it starts really like an amazing F-35A, guys. And I already received some comments from you guys about a C version F-35. Well, yeah, I'm planning also to do a C version after this A version. We will do another 70 with a C maybe. And then for next year, we're going to scale up the models to a 1-10 size, 1-10 size with all the details. And to give you a sneak preview, I'm even working on a 1-8 size. So this fits a 120mm EDF, also for Vital. But this project is still ongoing. But these are some background projects. We got also the Dornier, the Boeing H-32. So these are quite complicated projects. And keep in mind, guys, the Harrier is a really complicated model. If you point me someone else in the world who is already transitioning and flying a scale-built Harrier, not a lookalike, but fully scale, let me know. Because, yeah, the dream is still ongoing to make a functional F-35B and Harrier model for a 1-8 and maybe 1-6 size. Okay, so I'm waiting now for the printers to get finished. The minis are printing the ailerons. They are really wonderful and they print really amazingly. The H2Do is printing with the big part of the wing, and the X1s are printing the smaller parts of the wing. So yeah, you have to wait, and then we can continue building. And I already ordered a second H2Do. I really love the printer, and a third A1 Mini, so we can even boost the prints more faster. It's going really fast now. This I built it last week, and this one I built it this week, so I can build an entire airplane in just 1 week. Print and build in just 1 week. So super happy. Can you imagine if we got more of these, we can go even faster. So a special shout out to Colorfabb. I'm using the lightweight PLA with the natural color because I like to airbrush the model afterwards. I'm really happy with this foaming filament, and I use also the bamboo labs to make the parts really lightweight. So we use a single outline and a 3% gyroid infill, and that is how we can print with those bamboo labs really, really fast. So it just took me a week to print and build this model, and yeah, guys, I really need more printers, but again, Colorfabb, thank you for making really awesome filaments. And if you want to have more heat resist, sun resist, or UV protectors, you can also apply a small layer of glass fiber, 25 grams, and epoxy, and this will give also really a lot of strength to the model. So we're going to experiment quarterly four with bigger models, with printed fuselage parts with Colorfabb filaments, and we will lay up the inside and the outside of those fuselage parts with a small layer of epoxy and see if we can go even bigger. So we're pushing the boundary of technology, what we can do today with 3D printing combined with epoxy. Okay, let's continue the build, and I'm still waiting for those printers to be finished. Hi guys, which printer should I buy next? The H2Do, just let me know.
Well guys, it's been 6 o'clock in the morning on Sunday, and I started this morning, and it's now almost, bedtime, 8 o'clock. And finally, the wings are on and the F-35A is completed. Stunning, stunning, stunning. So I scaled her also a little bit off compared to the F-35B, because you can also fit a 80 millimeter inside. But let's see what weight this model has. I'm really, really proud. Okay guys, guess what weight? Pam 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 pam. 1000 grams, exactly 1000 grams. So all printed parts with magnets and carbon tubes inside, no electronics, 1 kilo. Wow, 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 wow. I cannot wait to test this model. And also for getting the air to breathe for the EDF, I made this extra inlet for breathing more air. So now she's ready for painting. Let's go for it. Oh, she's big. That's nice. That's really nice. And she looks pretty scale. You can see it with this angle from this side. The cockpit with the nose, it has to be this gap. Then you can see you got a nice F-35. If this is a straight line, with all due with all due respect to my competitors or colleagues who wants to build an F-35, sometimes you see a straight line, but the F-35 goes like this, really smooth. Amazing. So next stop is painting. Okay guys, 5 o'clock in the morning. Let's see. Oh my dear, it's early, but we're going to build something and to spray something. Let's turn on the lights first to continue. Here we go. So we're going to apply the base coat for the F-35, that special gray, and we're going to finish up that nose. Let's go for it.
Amazing guys, they are both back in color. Woohoo.
She looks stunning, isn't it? So if you like this build, please give me that big thumbs up and hit that like button to help me with the YouTube algorithm. Okay, 1 kilos. So now we're going to continue adding the truss arrows, electronics, the JP-EDF, and so I need to design some landing gears. So for the landing gears, these are self-made. We're going to use 10 millimeter tubes, inner 8 millimeter tubes with a spring and 3D printed scissors. So yeah, I think this will be going to be cool to keep the weight low, because I want to fly high alpha. By the way guys, now you can see the details really awesomely. I really hope I deserve a like, because this model took a lot of work. Okay guys, let's start electronics, and a new JP has arrived, so let's unpack it and build it into the F-35. We got the unit. Cool. Okay guys, so we got ailerons, elevator, flapperons, and we got yaw momentum, and we got our trowel. Cool.
What I always do with wiring, I use this flexible line. So when I pull this, I can just use a piece of tape to guide the wire through the bolts. And I also make sure to bend this one to show you can search it easily to the model. So let's continue. And there you have it, the F-35A version, the RC jet print model with the free wing Avanti gears. I really love it. All electronics are installed and the total amount of weight is now 1.8 kilos. So including with the battery pack, which is, let me see, 679, let's say 700, we are aiming at 2.5 kilos, and this is exactly what I want because the JP can push 2.8 kilos. So I'm super happy. So we got four of the DS06 from Char Servo, two of the DS09, the JP, filaments from Colorfabb. Thank you so much, Colorfabb. And next week we're going to do a maiden flight. So thanks all for watching. Thumbs up and please consider to support us on Patreon because these projects are not that cheap. Thank you so much for watching, guys. See you next time.